First of all, let me thank Professor Vasco Pereira de Silva and Dr. Dimitrios Parashu for their kind invitation to contribute to the ELPIS Willow Review, Volume 3, 2021, which is focused on Law in a Space Odyssey, Robots, Computer, Digitalization as the New Challenge to the Law. I am Maria Cristina Gaeta and I am Research Fellow in Private Law at Sor Orsola Benincasa, University of Naples, Italy, as well as Scientific Secretary of the RESEP, the Research Center in European Private Law, based at the same university. Today, my talk is entitled Artificial Intelligence and Civil Liability in the Light of the Artificial Intelligence Act Proposal. Coming to the summary of my presentation, it will be divided in four parts: from automation to artificial intelligence, liability profile, security, cybersecurity, data protection, and ethics, EU regulation proposal for Artificial Intelligence Act, and conclusion. Starting from the step from automation to artificial intelligence, let me give a definition of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is a kind of intelligence, if we can define AI in this way, which is divided into a set of theoretical foundation methodologies and technique that allows the design hardware and software capable of implementing performance in scientific domain and areas of application considered for a variety of time to be an exclusive domain of the human being. AI has a multiple application and it can be divided in embodied robotics and unembodied robotics. One of the most developed sector of AI is the smart mobility, but we also have smart toys and online platforms, search engine, and so on. The higher of the level of automation is, the more is possible to achieve artificial intelligence. All autonomous and AI system must to be programmed, so it is important to understand what's programming consisting in, because programming is the elaboration of algorithms which have the ability to self-implement machine learning, deep learning, self-correction, meta-learning, and so on. At all the level of regulation, the awareness of the need for a concrete strategy and regulation of artificial intelligence has matured. The latest academic discussion has focused on the legal issues relating to development of artificial intelligence. Specific awareness is arising on the potential and the risk associated with technological system. In this perspective, defining legal but also ethical principles, in particular for the cases of AI damages, is needed in order to develop trustworthy and anthropocentric artificial intelligence, putting it at the service of the human being and limiting their risk. So, starting to this definition of artificial intelligence is necessary in order to regulate AI, understand the artificial intelligence behavior. Under my point of view, there are two different ways to consider the artificial intelligence behavior. One is the human thinking and human acting, and the second one is the rational thinking and rational acting. When we think about the possibility to consider artificial intelligence as more similar possible as human, we are referring to the possibility to consider artificial intelligence system thinking like a human and acting like a human. It means cognitive modeling and human behavior. This is, of course, a human-centered approach, which aims to try to make artificial intelligence similar to the human being and is based on empirical studies, of course, cognitive science, and of course, in particular, neuroscience. Rational behavior is different, and under my point of view is the best solution to classify artificial intelligence behavior, because artificial intelligence systems think rationally and artificial intelligence systems act rationally. It means that are based on the law of thought, which is the Aristotelian syllogism, and they are rational agents that are not governed by patience. Coming to the second part of our presentation, civil liability profiles, under my point of view, there are four kinds of liability profiles that should be taken into account. Of course, safety, the safety of the product, because if the product in the case is the artificial intelligence system is not safe, it can cause physical and psychological injuries for the user of the artificial intelligence system, as well as to the third parties. At the same time, if the artificial intelligence device is not safe, it can cause physical damage of the same device, a component of the device, or the surrounding environment. The European legislation for product liability is Product Liability Directive of 1985, number 374. Of course, this regulation is quite ancient, so it's important to understand if it can be apply to this new phenomena, or it should be better to introduce an ad hoc regulation. Concerning the cybersecurity, it means the security in the cyber domain, of course, are very current possibility of cybersecurity breach of the artificial intelligence system or of a component of the artificial intelligence system, for example, the software. In Europe, in 2017, entered in force and is applicable since 2018, the NIS Directive, number 1148. It is a good regulation and is quite recent, but maybe not provide all the kind of cybersecurity breach in the case of artificial intelligence application. And then we have the data breach, which is strictly connected to the cybersecurity, because one of the cases in which privacy can be processed unlawful is a consequence of a cybersecurity breach. All the cases of data breach are related to privacy, in particular data protection, and are regulated under GDPR. I don't think GDPR needs presentation. It's a really recent regulation, again, entered in force in 2016 and applicable since 2018. It is a recent legislation, but again, like for the NIS directive, maybe even though it provides technological scenarios, it's not specifically focused on artificial intelligence domain. Finally, the last type of injury that can be caused by an artificial intelligence system is that of is related to ethical domain. In particular, artificial intelligence application can create emotional ties, can create psychological manipulation, can create discrimination. As a direct consequence of the four kinds of injuries that has been explained, there should be two types of damages. First of all, liability for property damages to the artificial intelligence system or to the surrounding environment. And secondly, liability for psychological injury, data breach, psychological manipulation, personal injury. Considering this kind of injuries, the question is the following: is the regulatory issues? Is the existing legislation functional, efficient, and effective, even if applied to robotics and artificial intelligence? Or is it necessary to introduce a framework of rules? And in this case, what kind of rules would we need? international, European and national organizations in the public and private sector issued numerous of soft law act reports, studies and guidelines on new technologies and specifically AI system that highlight the need to regulate this phenomena. Until the publication of the Artificial Intelligence Act proposal, all the EU initiatives related to the automation and artificial intelligence were mainly based to soft law and have depended over the last 5 years, from 2017 to 2021. The protagonists of the debate are the European Parliament and the European Commission, of course, while the former seemed certain from the outset of the need to intervene to provide specific rules for robotics and artificial intelligence, first of all in the European Parliament resolution of 2017 on civil law rule for on robotics. The European Commission initially considered completely effective the existing regulation also applied to new technologies, in particular the Product Liability Directive, as was stated in the Quinquennial Report and the Staff Working Document of the European Commission of 2018. Coming to the third part of our presentation, it's now the time to in-depth the European Regulation Proposal for Artificial Intelligence Act of the 21st April 2021, when it will finish the legislative iter for the entering in force of the legislation. It will be applicable 2 years after the publication of the regulation and the entering in force of the regulation. In the European proposal for AI, artificial intelligence systems are defined as software developed with one or more techniques and approaches as indicated in the Annex 1 of the regulation and can generate output such as content, prediction, recommendation, or decision influencing the environment they are interacting with. In particular, three approaches came into account: machine learning approach, logic and knowledge-based approach, and statistical approach. The parties involved in the Artificial Intelligence Act are defined as operator and are the one listed in the slide. For a question of times, we will not in-depth all the single operator, but we will move forward to the main point of the AI Act proposal, which is the risk-based approach. It means that the artificial intelligence technologies are divided in three categories: the prohibited, the high risk, and the low risk. The prohibited use are considered prohibited because are in contrast with the EU values or because they violate the fundamental rights of the individual guaranteed by the European Union. The prohibited uses of AI is regulated under Article 5, which expressly provide the cases in which the AI technologies are provided. And of course, they are related to the hypothesis in which AI distort a person's behavior, or AI can be used to evaluate or classify a natural person in with particular regard to its trustworthiness, and the use of real-time remote biometric identification system in public area for the law enforcement, with some exception, of course. High-risk AI systems are admitted under strict requirement for the use, and they are AI system intended to be used as a safety component of product or as a product in certain areas referred to Annex 2 of the proposal, AI system required to undergo a third-party conformity assessment with a view to the placing on the market or putting into service of the system, and of course are listed in article in Annex 2 of the proposal, and all the other iLISC AI application listed in Annex 3 of the proposal. The list of Annex 3 of the proposal should be updated by the EU Commission through an ad hoc act as provided according to Article 7 of the AI Act proposal. The European proposal is divided to an ex-ante protection and an ex-post protection. In relation to an ex-ante protection, is provided that all the high-risk AI system, before to placing them on the market or putting to into service, should undergo a compliance assessment with respect to the requirement provided according to Article 9 and following of the proposal, which are risk management system, EU of high quality data set, technical documentation, logging of activities, transparency obligation, human oversight, and robustness, accuracy, and cybersecurity requirement, which should be applied through the life cycle of the artificial intelligence system. Concerning the ex post protection from high risk AI system, there are two measures. Post-market requirements, it means monitoring system, reporting of serious accident, and so on, as well as market surveillance, control of the AI system by independent national and European authorities in order to assess whether physical or psychological harms are occurred. In my opinion, there are several points in common and similarities between the European Union proposal for AI regulation and the GDPR. This is a thesis that is well spread around the literature across Europe. And in this slide are listed the most evident similarities between the two legislation, the proposal of the AI Act and the GDPR, which is of course in full. They regard the external scope, the application of the regulation, the accountability principle, the EU representative obligation for provider outside the European Union, the European Artificial Intelligence Board, as well as the National Supervisory Authority and the European Committee for Artificial Intelligence, the incident notification, the same exactly penalties provided by the GDPR, and the codes of conduct as provided also in the GDPR regulation. Let me give my point of view on this artificial intelligence regulation proposal. The threshold of the risk-based approach are directly defined by the European Commission. It means that they are limited under a case-by-case analysis. There are not general rules to define this risk artificial intelligence system. Risk-based approach is applicable only to the foreseeable risk. This is a very huge limit because it means that for the unforeseeable risk, we are not able to define the AI system as prohibited, high risk, or lawful. And then, under my point of view, the risk threshold related to AI system are too general. Therefore, if interpreted extensively, many AI systems are prohibited, limiting the use of development of new technologies. On the other side, if they are interpreted in a restrictive way, it means that a lot of AI systems should be admitted and they can create damages for the human beings that entered into contact with the technology. There are many doubtful cases in which it's not easy to understand what is allowed and what is provided. And these cases damages to innovation and business in the European Union. Regulatory lack related to low risk technologies are not regulated. It means that in all the cases of low risk technologies, it's not easy to understand the consequences of the action and in what cases this kind of low risk technologies can become to considered high risk. Finally, coming to the conclusion, artificial intelligence must be programmed, but what is the programming based on? Legal regulation, of course, are the law and soft law, including the codes of conduct, standards, example ISO or IEC standard, and ethics, ethical principle that can be included in the field of soft law, but can also be used in a way of techno regulation as ethic by design. The problem is very evident. Programmer must also make ethical choices in programming the algorithm, but how do they choose what is right and what is wrong? What they should do in the case of moral dilemmas? Furthermore, choices are based on the so-called pre-understanding of the human being. So, coming to the point, the final point of our presentation, how to regulate artificial intelligence, the existing legislation extensively interpreted versus a framework of legal and ethical rules for artificial intelligence, with particular regard to its possible damages. This is the point. Under my point of view, currently, we can still learn towards an extensively application of the existing regulation of the artificial intelligence field. However, to allow a linear and controlled development of artificial intelligence is still necessary to continue in the direction of the periodic review of current legislation in order to verify its applicability to the new scenario characterized by the quick development of new technologies or the need to intervene by modifying it. Although in part it's still possible to go for an extensive interpretation of the existing rules, the need to introduce a regulatory framework of rules for artificial intelligence cannot be ignored. Furthermore, a general law for artificial intelligence will not be the solution to regulate the different legal types of artificial intelligence. Therefore, in some specific sectorial legislation will be needed. What type of regulatory framework do we need? Of course, hard law, but also soft law, as well as standard and techno regulation. Example, the so-called data protection, security, and ethics by design, applied under an interdisciplinary point of view that can guarantee safety-minded ethic design, and maybe, of course, also an EU certificate of ethical compliance as was provided. This could be considered maybe the ethical legal principle for the regulation of the AI. Of course, the strengthening and the concretization of the principle of accountability, the provision of trustworthy AI, a human-centered artificial intelligence, putting it at the service of the man, respecting human autonomy in the light of the social and more generally environmental well-being. Robust artificial intelligence from a technical perspective, but also social perspective. Risk management system, liability rules for the AI damages that was underlined in the first part of our presentation. Insurance risk for AI application. Of course, monitoring and supervisory authority at national and European level, and finally, high fines in case of artificial intelligence damages. With this, I stop my presentation here, and I really thank you for the attention.